Thank you for joining me. Today we'll see how to use conditional formatting to indicate which of these numbers are within this range. We have sales figures for different products across different months. The base target is 50. Stretch target is 70. So if you achieve more than 70, it is good. You get incentives. Between 50 and 70 is fine, and below 50 is poor performance. In order to use conditional formatting, you select the data first and choose what is the condition and what is the formatting. So in this case, we are going to use icon sets. It looks like there are too many icons, but don't get confused. For now, we are talking about good sales, bad sales, and okay sales. So we will use directional three arrows icon. As of now, Excel seems to have decided on its own where to put yellow, where to put green. So let's find out what it has done. Conditional formatting, manage rules, and edit the rule. What it does is it looks at your data, finds out the range, the minimum, maximum. Maximum minus minimum is the range. It divides the range into three equal parts. 0 to 33%, 33 to 67%, and 67 and above. So 67 and above gets green, 33 to 67 is yellow, and below 33% is red. That is why the percent option is selected here by default. In our case, we don't want that. We want actual value of target and stretch target to be applied here. So instead of percent, we choose number in both cases. Delete the zero and associate this with the target. We'll do the same thing for the stretch target. And that's it. Now the conditional formatting is driven by the target and stretch target numbers. I'm going to reduce the stretch target to 60. Suppose I increase the target to 55. If I increase the target to 80, there'll be more yellow. Like that, now we can control the visualization. Sometimes what we want is only show the problematic values. So green and yellow, I don't want to show. How do we control that? Go to edit rules. Now here, each of these icons has a drop down. What does that mean? I can choose not to show this icon at all by saying no sale icon. And I'll do the same thing for yellow as well. Now we can focus on the red values or the problematic sales figures only. Another common requirement is I want to copy paste this into a PowerPoint for presentation. While presenting, I don't want the audience to read all these numbers and get confused. So I only want to show the icon. That is also done easily by editing the rule. All that you have to say is show icon only. Now the only extra thing you need to do is to center align the icon. Now this will look much better in a presentation. It'll be clearer and without clutter. There is much more available in conditional formatting. We will have another video coming soon. So if you like what you saw, subscribe and click the bell icon so that when I publish more videos, you'll be notified immediately. If you like this, please share it with your friends and colleagues. So that's all for now. Thank you. See you soon.